Hello, in today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to lay off passport photos using Photoshop. When you open Photoshop, it looks like this. Now, what we're going to do is come in here to open. Now, this is the image which you're going to be using. You double click on it, and it will be opening like this. This is the image which you are going to be turning into a passport photo. What you need to do is coming to this layer here, and then you press Ctrl J. After pressing Ctrl J, you would have copied this layer up here, and then you come to the down layer. We are going to be putting a white background on this down layer. You come here to this button over here, and then you select solid background and solid color. On solid color, you're going to be choosing white, and that is okay. Then afterwards, you come and select this upper layer here, which is your copy, and then you come here to the crop button. On your crop button, you must make sure that ratio is selected and the height should be 1.5 by 2 inches. Now what you're going to do is coming here and then reduce the size, and then you move the image inside to make sure that it is perfect for a passport photo. Then you press done. After pressing done, you're going to export this image. You come here to file, export PNG, and then save. After saving that particular image, what you're going to do is now we are going to be creating another new canvas which you're going to lay our images on. You press Ctrl N, which is Ctrl New, and then you pick the size which is according to the paper which you're going to be printing on. In most cases, I use 4 by 6 inches, so I'm going to select 4 by 6, and then I say create. You should make sure that the inches selected 4 by 6. Then we are going to be using a orientation which is the landscape orientation, 300 resolution. The setting should be like this, and the color of the background should be white, and then you say create. Now this is the where we're going to lay our images on. Now we're going to come here to file, place embedded. When you come to place embedded, you're going to be adding this image which we exported. You say place, and after pressing it, this is how the images appears. You reduce its size to a size which is comfortable, and after that, you place it at the corner, you say done. And after saying done, one thing you're going to do is come here to f of x, you put there a stroke. The stroke should be at least the size should be 1, the opacity 100, and the color is black, so that you can put a border on our image. Then you press OK. And after pressing OK, you are going to now come and select, press Alt. You select this image so that you can be able to copy those images and align them to where they are. And afterwards, with this move tool selected, you're going to press anywhere, and then you scroll so that you can select all these images. And after selecting all of them, you should make sure that you increase their size so that they can fit your background paper. And afterwards, you're going to come back to your select image, select, and then you're going to also select, again select all of them, and then you press Alt so that you can copy all those images which you have put up there and make sure that they are all in line. This is how you can lay the passport photos in Photoshop so easy. So the next thing is that you're going to come back to your select tool. You double click on any of the images, then you come to your select tool, you select all these images, and then you increase their size so that you can make sure that they fit the background which you have applied on them. The next thing is obviously to print. You press Ctrl P to print your images. Now, this is how they have shown you that they would appear, but this is not the actual settings. So what you need to do is first of all increase your size, the size of your images, so that you can fit the whole paper or the whole page, something like that. And afterwards, you can come here to printer settings, and then you change, you should make sure that color is selected, And here, instead of A4, you should make sure that if you're going to print on 4x6 inch, you select 4x6 inch here, and you should select borderless. This should be landscape as it is, and then you press OK. And after pressing OK, you can see that my images would have moved. So you can come down here, and down here where you're having position and size, you should select scale to fit the media, and afterwards you print your images out. And that's it for today. If you have enjoyed this video, I request you to subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video.